It is Friday and it is September 22nd. I am here to do a keto update. If you guys have never seen my channel, I am Ashley and I have been on keto for the last 2 months, going on 2.5 now. I am down about 30 pounds and 30 inches. Last time I checked, I normally check on Sundays once a week, maybe sometimes two. I'm really, really excited about keto, and I'm going to start looking into actually keto coaching because I'm having really high success with it. And also, I've been having a lot of people come to me asking me what is keto and how do they get started, because my before and after pictures speak for themselves. I am so stoked. It's so hard to explain to you guys unless you've been through a whole weight loss thing. It's incredible to see the progress right in front of you, and that's exactly what happened with me. The scale has never been my friend, let me tell you, but the second that I started measuring and looking at the picture side by side, it's crazy. This is what I'm talking about. Isn't that great? Oh, I can see such a big difference, and people are so excited for me. This has literally been the easiest thing that I think I've ever done to lose weight, and it's actually been the most successful as well. Most of the time when I have been on other diets, I have done just like 2 weeks and then gotten really frustrated with it and completely just said, you know what, screw it. So keto works, and I am working on getting a lot of information for people out there who want my help with it. If you have any questions you would like answered, feel free to post them in the comments below. It's something that I'm working on. It's in the works, as they say. My keto coaching, I'm getting Facebook stuff together, and it's something that I'm working towards. Now, the one thing that I wanted to talk to you guys today about is keto and exercise. Throughout this whole entire week, I've been researching just to kind of put it all in one place for you guys. I'm not going to do daily videos just because my routine during the week is pretty much the same. I get up, I get lunch and stuff ready for my husband, get my kid up, get her ready to go to school, and then I get myself to work, and then I come home, and that's about it. I go to the gym every other day if I can, depending. This week I've been really exhausted. So if you've seen my other videos, you kind of know about my deficiency, and I think it might possibly either have something to do with that because I'm taking my vitamin D pills every other day because it's a higher dosage. So it could have something to do with that, but I'm not too sure. The other thing too is sleep has really not had an importance to me this last week. You know how when you, it seems like a waste of time for me. So I'm so busy doing other things that I just don't want to go to bed and I don't want to stop. So my husband actually gets pretty mad at me telling me that I need to go to bed early, but I try and go to bed at 9 and end up going to bed at like 1. My bad. Anyway, so I've been really exhausted this week, but it's been a really good week, you know? So the thing that I wanted to talk to you guys again, like I said, was exercise with keto. It is totally okay. The one thing I was worried about was I remembered hearing something somewhere about when you work out and your muscles tear as you work out, something builds up in them. And I wasn't too sure because it would actually have kind of a reverse effect, I guess. I wasn't too sure. So I wanted to research it and share what I found with you guys, because I'm sure there are other people out there who want to exercise, right? It's totally fine on keto. My research has led me to believe something that I think is actually really good advice, not to overdo it. And instead of the cardio, to just do like weightlifting reps and resistance training, squats, planks, push-ups, those type of things, to where you're kind of working against your own body, that will give you the best results. Because here's the reason, and this is something I didn't even know until I started researching this. When we do high intensity cardio workouts, especially when we do it for a long extended period of time, something in our body builds up and it's called cortisol. And you guys have probably heard of cortisol. We don't want that in our system. We want that as low as possible. So the cortisol, when our body's under stress, it's the stress hormone, right? And there's been commercials around, so I'm sure that you guys have seen it. Cortisol is not our friend at all. And it does a lot of different things. It makes our blood sugar go up. It's something that you want to manage because it does nasty things, and it's a vicious circle with cortisol. It breaks down our muscle tissues, and then it kind of, the glucose has been stored in our muscles as glycogen. It liberates that. It breaks down the proteins into amino acids, which can then also be turned into blood sugar. So again, we're going back to the glucose. Too much glucose, they store the glycogen, and it's just a vicious, vicious circle. We want to stay away from the glucose. We want to stay away from the glycogen. We want to stay away from the blood sugar. You know, we want to stay away from the cortisol. It can also break down the fatty acids and turn those into blood sugar or glucose. Cortisol sucks. So what will happen is you'll have a decrease in your muscle. You'll have a less of a metabolic rate, which is the rate you're burning calories when you're resting. And then the less calories that are burned means that you might actually be adding the visceral fat, the hard fat that's around your stomach and your midsection. So that's definitely not good. It also leads to insulin resistance and diabetes and inflammation. Cortisol is a nasty thing, my friends. It also leads to increased cravings and appetite. Your stress is going to make cortisol go up. Doing high intensity workouts, that's going to make your cortisol go up because your inflammation will go up. Definitely not a good thing. So that's why I'm saying on keto, all of my research is saying the same thing. Low resistance, you know, strength training rather than the high intensity cardio kick-ass workouts. So I hope that helps you guys if you were kind of curious about working out on keto. And if you guys want any more information, just let me know. I have tons of it. A lot of good videos that I've seen, I'm gonna post links to down below. I literally had like 8 tabs open on my computer at all times. I was going back and forth. Dr. Berg, man. Stephanie person, keto something or other, she's awesome. One of the things that I really liked about her videos, she was like, the first half of your day, you know, go to work, get stressed out. Well, try not to, but get stressed out, do your exercise, and then the second half of your day, 5 p.m., cut it off. Do your meditation, do your relaxation. That's time for rest and recuperating and repairing. And so the second half needs to be chill, right? Amazing. And it's watching these people that you just, light bulbs go off, right? And they make complete sense. So that's really what I loved about doing my research. And like I said, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video, that it gave you some information that maybe you didn't know. I didn't know it. That's why I wanted to do the research and I wanted to share it with you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. And if you haven't already, please like and subscribe. You can comment if you want to, if you have any questions. All right. Hope you guys have a really great weekend.